This is an introduction to scientific notation. Let's start with the number 1,000. 1,000 may be written as 10 times 10 times 10, which is the same as writing it as 10 raised to the third power. Since the number 3,000 is 3 times bigger than 1,000, we can write it as 3 times 1,000, or 3 times 10 to the third. And since 6,700 is 6.7 times as big as 1,000, we can write it as 6.7 times 1,000, or 6.7 times 10 to the third. Looking at a smaller number, such as 0.001, we would read it as 1/1,000th, so it could be written as 1 over 1,000. Since 1,000 is the same as 10 to the third, we could then write it as 1 over 10 to the third, which would be the same as writing it as 10 raised to the negative third power. A number that is 3 times as big would be written as 0.003, which would be read as 3/1,000ths, which would be the same as 3 times 10 to the negative third. Finally, if we looked at the number 0.0067, this number would be 6.7 times as big as 1/1,000th, and we could write it as 6.7 times 10 to the negative third. Now, another way of writing this number would be as 1 times 10 to the third power, and another way of writing this number would be as 1 times 10 to the negative third power. All of the numbers in the last column are written in proper scientific notation. Numbers written in proper scientific notation have two characteristics. We have a number in front of the multiplication sign that is always a number between 1 and 10. Actually, it never quite gets up to 10, it can get up to 9.999, etc., but never quite 10. The number after the multiplication sign is always written as 10 raised to an integer value. That integer value can either be positive, negative, or 0. If the exponent on 10 is positive, that tells us we're dealing with a really big number. And if the exponent on 10 is negative, that tells us we're dealing with a really small number. It's as simple as that. We don't need to know whether to move the decimal place left or right. Just remember that really big numbers have positive exponents, and really little numbers have negative exponents. To write a number in scientific notation, such as 71,300,000, we need to count the number of places we move the decimal to wind up with a number between 1 and 10. In this case, we wind up with the number 7.13, and we had to move the decimal a total of 7 places. Since the number is really big, we have a positive exponent, and we'd read the number as 7.13 times 10 to the 7th. To write the number 0.0000036 out in scientific notation, we wind up with the number 3.6 after moving the decimal a total of 7 places. Since the number is really small, we would then have a negative exponent, and the number would be read as 3.6 times 10 to the negative 7th. Next, if we'd like to write the number 1.44 times 10 to the negative 4th out in its standard form, we'd recognize that this is a really small number since we have a negative exponent. This means we need to move the decimal to the left. We move it to the left a total of 4 places. We fill in the spaces with zeros, and we wind up with a value of 0.000144. Finally, to write the number 9.8 times 10 to the 14th out in its standard form, we recognize that this is a really big number since the exponent is positive. We move the decimal a total of 14 places, filling in the spaces with zeros, and we wind up with 980 trillion.